everybody's question and sharing. If anyone wants to share quickly, we can do that during this time.
Hello, good evening, Brother Shanti Pinto here.
Yeah,
Shanti. Yesterday, you spoke, Brother Johnson spoke to my on my husband.
Yeah.
Yesterday night onwards, I getting message that BP is dropping severely. And this oxygen level, what is this? Saturation is detecting. Nothing is showing. So morning again, we got a call. So after 12 days, I saw today his face is in ventilator.
Okay.
So finally, they allowed me to saw my husband. There I saw him. The again, BP is dropping.
Okay.
Saturation level is not detecting.
Okay.
And they are giving CPR. What is that? The CPR means the chest. They are pushing the chest to oxygen. CPR they are giving.
Mm.
Because earlier he arrested cardio, so all parts of damage it seems. Mm. Again, it is in critical condition.
Mm.
Even without any way, you will get call. So I'm praying to Jesus to the miracle.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, sister, you saying something?
No, I'm depending on Jesus to finally do one, some miracle.
Yeah.
Jesus has raised up Lazarus from last.
So let us, you have to just stick on to what the prayer, what Brother Johnson gave yesterday.
Yeah, I'm praying that one only.
That prayer only. You can also add 1 Corinthians 3:16. It says, my body is a temple of God's Holy Spirit. God's Spirit is dwelling in me. So there is, so, you know, you keep saying.
1 Corinthians 3:16.
Yeah. My body is a temple of God's Holy Spirit. God's Spirit is dwelling in me. So let us, when you say this word, believe that your Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit is using your body as the residence. So your body is controlled by the Holy Spirit. God's Spirit is dwelling in your body, not only in your body, even in your husband's body. So we believe this and we declare this. We don't do any other prayer other than what you have been told. So friends, let us together claim the word in Mark 16, 17 and 18. Let us together pray for Gerald Prakash Pinto. Let us if we can pray in tongues for some time, let us do that. We will trust in the Lord, and we believe the word of God says in Mark 16, 17 and 18 says, these signs will accompany you. In my name, they will cast out devils. They will speak new tongues. They will pick up serpents. If they drink anything deadly, it will not hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and the sick will be healed. Lord, we believe in this word. Lord, we believe in this word. 91 of us, Lord Jesus, we believe, who are present here in this group, Lord Jesus. Lord, when Peter was put in the jail, Lord Jesus, and when the believers prayed together, Lord, your power was released upon Peter, and he was released miraculously from the jail. Today, Lord Jesus, we pray. Lord Jesus, we pray life upon this child of yours, Lord Jesus, who is struggling, Lord. Lord, your word will not fail, we believe, Lord Jesus. Lord, we believe your word will not fail, Master. Right now, we believe, as in one community, in one heart, we believe, Lord. Lord, we believe your word once again. Lord, these signs will accompany those who believe. Then in my name, they will cast out demons. Thank you, Lord, for healing this man, O Master, for delivering this man, Lord. Lord, we trust in you, Lord Jesus.
Come on.
Thank you, Lord, for pouring out your compassion upon her, O Lord Jesus. Thank you for pouring out your compassion upon the child of yours, O Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, thank you for healing him, O Lord. Thank you for healing him, O Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you for speaking your spirit, O Lord. Hallelujah.
Come on, 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 come on
Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hi, brother. Over to you.
Praise God. I'm so sorry.
No problem.
Praise God.
Praise God.
So, looking at what Shanti was speaking,
yeah.
Let's go to 2 Corinthians 4, 17 and 18.
Papa, 1 minute, Papa.
Okay, I'll read it by the time it comes. For a light affliction, which is but for a moment. Yeah.
Open money is
Baba, mute.
For this light momentary affliction is preparing us for an eternal weight of glory beyond all measure.
Then,
because we look not at what can be seen, but at what cannot be seen. For what can be seen is temporary, but what cannot be seen is eternal.
Now, when a person is listening to the words like this, it looks like Paul has gone out of his mind. How can you look at things which are seen? How can you look at things which are unseen? Because obviously, a person will look at things which are seen. But here he's saying, no, we don't look at the things which are seen, but we look at things which are unseen. So, how can a person look at things which are unseen? Now, when he's saying things unseen and things seen, what Paul is talking about is not the things seen and unseen. He's talking about the principles. Paul is talking about unseen principles, the principle of God's word. Now, let me give the principles. For example, if you put oil in the water, what will happen?
The oil will float.
Why will it float? Why it won't go down?
It is, the density is lesser.
Yeah. So if the gas is on and you put a match,
it will burn.
It will catch fire. Why? Because it's a principle.
Yeah.
If you put a reverse gear and you look in front, the car will still go back. Because it's a principle.
Yeah.
So in the same way, when Paul is saying we look at things unseen, he's talking about God's word principles. So the principle of God's word, which are actually spiritual laws. What is a law? A law is a force which has been tried. That whosoever gets involved in it, the result is always going to be the same. But the law of gravity means what? Everything is pulled down. It's a law. So also the word of God is a spiritual law which has principles. And this spiritual force is unseen. So there are spiritual forces that are unseen, and these spiritual force are eternal forces which always work. Now remember this, which always work when you and I set them in motion.
Yeah.
I repeat again, these are spiritual forces or eternal forces which always work when you and I set them in motion. So unless you activate it, those forces will not work. Are you understanding, brother?
Yeah.
So if you are looking only at seen things, means things of the natural, then the affliction will not work. An exceeding weight of glory in you. It will only work while you're looking at things which are not seen. So again, while looking at things not seen is again coming back to the principles. So there is a spiritual law and there's a natural law. So when a person is operating on natural law, he's working on a lower law. But when a person is operating on spiritual law, he's working on a super higher law. And this super higher law has control over the natural law. So what we are learning every day over here in a Bible study is the spiritual laws of the Word of God. And all our life we have been learning natural laws. Our life is governed by natural laws. I believe what my eyes show.
Yeah.
I hear, I believe what my ears are saying.
Yeah.
I believe what I touch.
Yeah.
I believe what I smell. I believe what I taste. Because my senses are trained to believe and take action. But actually speaking, a person who is in the kingdom of God, he is not ruled by his senses. He is ruled by the spiritual laws, that is the Word of God.
Yeah.
So a person who learns to make a shift into the realm of the spiritual law and begin to look at things which are not seen with the natural eye. Okay. These are the ones who walk into the supernatural.
Okay.
So you look at things which are not seen with the eye of the spirit. And what is that eye of the spirit? The eye of faith. So remember, when you speak faith, it always speaks about evidence not seen. But it speaks about the confidence, the assurance, the title deed, the surety, the realization, the substance of things hoped for. So faith is my confidence on that spiritual law, even though I cannot see it with my eyes. And that becomes a real challenge. So all afflictions will work a far exceeding great of glory? No. Not all. But those afflictions, where the person who is going through affliction is now looking not at things which are seen, but is looking at things which are not seen. So the conclusion is very simple. When I have an attitude like a thermometer, taking, reading what's happening around me continuously, my faith cannot stand. Because the more and more I'm concentrating on looking at things which are seen, I cannot focus now on things which are not seen. But the same thing, if a person is focused on things which are unseen, then the person is growing his faith to believe much more the natural things. So ask a question to yourself, all of us. What are the things which are unseen, which are not seen? When you are going through a situation, what are the things that you are looking at, things unseen? Let's take an example. A person is going through a financial crisis. What does his bank statement say?
Nothing?
It gives you a debit balance, minus balance.
Negative balance.
Negative. Now, when you look at those negative balance, what comes to your mind?
What comes to my mind is there is absolutely, you know, gone. No hope and natural. No. I'm talking about natural response.
Yeah, natural. So you are under pressure.
Correct.
So now, will that pressure work for you or against you?
Against me.
So how do I turn that pressure to work for me?
I should see my bank balance being filled. With money. I don't know, you tell me. I would like to know that.
That's why I took money only.
Yeah.
Because I know money will excite juice.
It will not excite me, but definitely I have a requirement.
Okay. So let us take an example. A person has got financial pressure. Okay. Yeah. And if he keeps looking at that and keeps meditating on that, will his pressure keep on increasing on the negative side?
Yeah, it will increase on the negative side.
But if he learns to focus on the unseen, then it will bring glory, not the pressure of the affliction. Let me give you an example.
Yeah.
Go to Philippians 4, 6.
Do not worry about anything.
Now pause.
Yeah.
When a person is worried, what is he looking?
What is he?
When a person is worried, why is he worried?
He is worried because there is nothing, no hope for him.
Thermometer.
Because he is seeing what is seen.
Yeah.
Because he's focused on things which are seen.
Yeah.
So as long as he's doing that, is it going to build up his faith?
No.
Praise God. So now, will he be repeatedly running in his mind?
Yes.
So God has created man that what he repeatedly keep hearing, he will eventually start believing.
Yes.
So if he's going on hearing what the bank has said, what he has said, and she has said, he's going to believe all those things and he will get into unbelief. So does he need to fight that battle?
Yeah, he needs to fight the battle. So how will he fight the battle? What is the step?
Here is the Lord giving you. Do not worry about anything. Then,
in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God.
So now the pressure what you had, have you given it to God?
Pressure, I give it to God. Yes.
But how do you give it to God?
I give it to God with thanksgiving.
So when you are giving God the pressure with thanksgiving, now where are your cares?
Cares are in the hands of God.
So when the cares are given to the hands of God, do you experience peace of God?
Yes, I experience peace of God.
See, most of the time people don't experience peace of God, because they have not yet given.
Yeah, so now, that is
one.
So brothers, anyways, sometimes this kind of small, okay. So what I want to ask you is this, this giving is not easy, brother, into a lot of us. How can you make it easy? Now you saying that people say you surrender. Surrender is.
I would say surrender. I would say surrender.
So surrender in the sense, even giving,
What did I say? What you repeatedly hear, you will eventually start believing. Now, how many times are you hearing over and over again the report that came to you, which is negative? The more you are hearing it, the more you are being torn apart.
Yeah.
Now, instead of that, you start taking the word of God. Okay. And you take that some teaching, some scriptures, some explanation of scripture, and you go on hearing it. In the beginning, you won't feel like hearing it. But remember, the word of God is alive. The word of God is active. The word of God is sharper than two-edged sword. What I say is, when a person is in depression, you don't pray. You plug your ears, one track, and keep on playing it. Make it a 10-15 minutes track and keep on playing it over and over again. When your ears are hearing, no, that power of the enemy is breaking. It's like hot water is going into the bucket, the cold water is coming out. And the cold water which was there is slowly becoming warmer and warmer till it becomes hot. So if you follow that system of plugging into your ears and hearing the same thing over and over and over again, there is a spiritual warfare going on. And you will find a point where the breakthrough has come, that grip which was there of the enemy is breaking out. And once that person experiences the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your heart and mind in Christ Jesus. Okay. Very, very important is verse number 8, which many people fail. Look at verse number 8.
Verse number 8, Marit. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Oh, okay. So, which means this is applicable to every area of our life, you know, to be honest.
Yes. If you yes. Look. See, God will never ask you to do something which is not, you are not capable of.
Yeah.
So only if you do 6 and 7, okay, then 8 is possible. But if you are doing 6 and 7 and not doing 8, then 6 and 7 will, then 6 will come back again. Worry will come back again. So is it a continuous battle? Yes, it's a continuous battle. What's the battle? When you are forcefully doing, have you ever heard people saying that person is deliberately irritating me?
Yeah. I hear it every day at home. Children saying. Yes.
So this deliberately doing, it is deliberately speaking and thinking, even though you don't feel like.
Okay, yeah.
So what you deliberately do is, in other words, getting your mind off your problem. Deliberately. Forcefully.
So which
and
is...
Then, and then you begin to think on the things that are not seen.
So if you really look at right now, if you in the current corona situation, if you look at it, any conversation that you have, you know, especially I've been seeing, you know, hearing this very often whenever we have the office meetings and all. First 5-10 minutes, we discuss only about corona. How is in your country? How is in that country? This country? So then the analysis of this thing. By the time you finish this discussion, you have nothing else. You can't think of anything else, you know. So when you are filling your mind with anything which is not giving you peace, that is going to stop you from seeing the victory. Is that what it word 6, word 8 says, right? We are going against, exactly against the word 8, 4-8.
Brother Jose, the day you believe that words carry power. They carry life or they carry death. So if somebody wants to discuss about COVID and you get into that discussion, that means you are coming into agreement with that person.
Yeah, no, I mute my speaker these days. I only look at their lips movement and then wait for them to stop. Then they will get into the topic. I literally do that, brother, because for me, I don't want to get.
So why don't you tell them?
See, you can't tell some people, some cultures, you can't tell all these things. You know, people don't respect that. So might as well you keep away. That is, I do not know what I'm doing is right or not. I'm not saying that I'm doing is right, but as far as I am concerned, I don't want
okay,
to get.
You can listen. You can start with like this.
So when they ask me,
I'll give you a solution. Mm. You can tell them we started a beautiful meeting, and Jesus also started a beautiful meeting with a parable called the sower and the seed.
Yeah.
And we all sowers came this morning for the meeting, and we are scattering the seeds. In the last 5 minutes, I want you to think about what kind of seeds were we scattering. Baskalas.
Everybody don't understand this, brother. That is a problem.
So but your meeting is a Christian meeting, no?
Yeah, for now, and they ask me, I will say that I don't know what's happening because I don't have a TV at home, so I am totally
clueless. No. When they are asking you, that is the time for you to, the opportunity to preach the truth, no?
So I tell them that, you know, I don't, you know, think about it or discuss about it.
No.
What I say, yeah.
At that time, you say, you should have said, what I feel is, talking on these things is just like Jesus giving us a parable of seeds that fell along the pathway, the stony ground, and the thorny.
Yeah, next time I'll do
it. I would rather keep my heart. That's why the Bible says, guard your heart with great diligence and be vigilant. Because out of the heart flows issues of life.
Yeah. No, I still remember the example you gave me about that man who asked that the other fellow to keep the newspaper out, you know, the devil out, you know, that from his hand. That is very fresh in my mind. So
why don't you see those who are coming for the meeting, no? They are all Christians.
Yeah.
And they all can go and check with the Smith Wigglesworth how sensitive he was that he kept the newspaper out. So you say, I heard this, I began to wonder, don't we need to do the same?
Yeah.
Unless you plant the seed, how would the atom bomb get blasted, brother?
Yes. I'll do that next time.
That's why I enjoy talking to you. Because you will say, I will hear it and I will do it. Yeah. And you'll come back with great result.
No, but that is a very
today morning, I'll tell you. Today morning, the Hindu lady is preaching to a Christian lady in the hospital. The Hindu lady's child is on a death sentence. Okay. The Christian lady's baby is sick. And the Hindu lady is giving the Christian lady the scriptures. And then the Hindu lady is going and praying over the Christian lady's baby and saying, tomorrow morning when you get up, the heart will be absolutely normal. The Christian ladies are like a thermometer sitting and crying. And the Hindu lady is the thermostat who is introduced to Jesus only 1 month back. It is so much fun to listen to this testimony coming up every day. They come every day and they share. What is the improvement of the baby?
Oh, yeah.
So whatever the doctor says, no, this is not working. She sets the thermostat, not looking at what the doctor said. And she comes back and says, you know, it is over. I keep telling the doctor, give me reports of what is not working and I will fix it up for you. So what is she doing? She has learned not to look at the problems, but to look at those things that God has given us.
Yes.
I want, if anybody wants to see this topic now, you go to today's breakfast table at Melbourne, which we are having on the video, and you listen to both the ladies. Both the children are, the doctor said, nothing can be done. And now the doctors are amazed because everything is working now. The baby who could not sit, the physiotherapist is trying for the baby to sit few seconds. The mama goes and starts speaking on the thermostat and makes the baby sit at 10 o'clock till 2 o'clock. How do you feel like?
Yeah.
And the baby who could not hold a neck for a few seconds, the baby is holding a neck from 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock. How do you feel that?
Yeah.
So how is she doing? She's coming and telling us, okay, with all that she's learning from the scriptures.
Why, brother, why is it happening with some and why is it not happening with others?
You went to school?
Huh?
Did you go to school?
Yes.
In your school, why is it that the teacher spoke the lessons and some got full marks and some got failed?
Some did not learn. Yeah, that is a good answer. But is it because we in every, is it because of the lack of learning?
Okay. Let me ask you one thing.
Hmm.
It is like
the... I never had anything to do with God, neither the church.
Hmm.
But when I began to understand these truths,
hmm.
I did not spend half an hour or 1 hour.
Hmm.
I would spend 10 hours.
Oh.
So it was a 10 hours, 12 hours of continuous studying the word of God. Because the Bible says what you seek with all your heart, then you will surely find the Lord.
Mm.
But you are seeking the blessing, then how will you find the Lord?
Yeah, correct. That's a very good point, brother, that you made. Yes. Correct. So
when you're seeking the truth,
mm.
you are not only getting the Lord, mm. now he's giving you exact instruction what should be done.
Yeah.
And you're like, now, for example, if I'm saying I'm believing, do you think I'm saying with my own strength? It is because of his strength.
Yes.
It is he who has given the grace, and it is he who is teaching us to grow in our faith.
Mm.
I don't know, Elizabeth Matthew, okay. I've never seen her before.
Mm.
But now she came here, and when I said that, she was the first one to raise her hand and volunteer. From that day till today, I've never seen her bunking any class.
Yeah.
Okay. And I don't know what was her background before, but I know one thing, that a person who is seeking, now look at Jessie. She comes like, you know, she's going to a university with a notebook, pen, bin, everything. Now, is she interested only in writing or after writing, taking the notes and then practicing?
Yeah.
It is each one's desire, brother.
Yes. Yeah, I remember this one priest sharing his experience. He was diagnosed with a cancer last stage, and he was sent to a home where he has to prepare for his death.
Correct.
Yeah, he has to prepare for his death. His name is Father Dominic Valamani. Okay. He had to prepare. So he was so thin, he didn't have even energy to hold the full Bible, the Malayalam Bible. He was so thin because it was so heavy for him. So what he did was, anyway, he's going to die. The day he landed up on, you know, he landed up in that particular place. And he thought that somebody will come and, you know, take him to the thing, but there was nobody there. So he landed in front of the chapel, and the chapel was opened, and there was Blessed Sacrament. So he went there. There he sat, and he got some special grace. What he did was, he started taking these books, separating the books from the Bible, you know, Mark's gospel, John's gospel, and he started binding it so that he can hold it, okay, in his hand and read. In few months' time, he read and he, you know, by hearted 2000 verses, 2000, and he is completely healed. Today, he is one of the, most anointed top priests in Kerala. Lakhs of people attend his conventions, and there is a mighty day, and he's especially, he has got this grace of deliverance. So but what he's saying is true. I agree to that. Maybe you should pray today, brother, for this grace for all of us who are attending this Bible study, to break that that bondage, to come out of that bondage, to dedicate the time to read the word of God. That has to happen in our life.
Brother, you know, the distractions in this world is
too much, yes.
Okay. So, what are you getting attracted to?
Mm.
So, if you are attracted to the word of God, no, then the world distraction doesn't affect you.
Yes.
You take 2 days off from the word of God, see what happens.
Yeah.
Everything comes back.
Yeah.
So if a person is feeding himself with the word of God day and night, okay, it's not that he got deliverance. The word only delivered him.
Yes, yes. Correct, correct.
See, like, you know, the person is all gripped with all the things like this, okay? And he's only concentrating on one line and is speaking and speaking and speaking. The more he's speaking, he doesn't realize, but this grip is getting loosed and it's falling apart. Deliverance is only this much.
Yeah.
So the more and more deliberately you sit, in the beginning you don't feel like, but you sit and you start reading and start repeating and start repeating, you don't even feel anything is happening.
Yeah.
The more you feel not to quit, it means the more it is working. That's why the devil is giving you those thoughts to quit. So when the person is doing it over and over again, he is getting totally delivered. And the seed that has been planted now in his heart is going to bring so many things supernatural, because see, you are natural. The word in your heart is super. So when they both get together, your life becomes supernatural.
Yes.
If you ask me from morning till night, what do? I have only one thing to do. So, nice for you. No. Before I reach nice for me, I had to let go of my business. I had to let go of my money. I had to let go of many things.
Yeah.
In exchange. And it and for somebody will say, how did you close the running factory? What became big, more treasure for me was not the money, but the treasure of the kingdom of God. That's why Jesus said, no, the one who found this treasure will go and sell everything to go and buy the treasure. So it doesn't come that, you know, somebody said, you know, pray over me and then it will work. Yeah. It doesn't work that way.
Yeah.
The person has to seek with all his heart. I will. Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
So the word is saying that everything that is natural is subject to change. So things that I'm seeing with my physical natural eye are always subject to change, but through spiritual law. Now, what did the priest do? When he was sitting and studying, that he could not pick up the Bible, he took those pages and began to study, okay, in small parts, okay? He was activating the spiritual law and he did not bother about cancer.
Yes.
The spiritual law took care of cancer. So when a person understands that and keeps activating the spiritual law day and night, everything around you will fall apart. Now, was he practicing Philippians 4:8?
Yes.
So when he's practicing 4:8, will God of peace be with him?
Yes.
So when God of peace is with him, does he need to worry? See what he's saying. Verse number 9. Keep on doing
things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. Okay.
So if the God of peace is there, will cancer remain now?
No.
So when you look at things which are seen, I'll tell you, things which are seen and things which are unseen are never in agreement.
Yeah.
So what your physical eyes does is, it teaches you not to agree with the word of God. So promise of God is saying something and your physical eyes are saying something. So there is a disagreement. So the world system shapes the seen things around me. The world's education. Now, for example, your children are going to school. Are they taught in academics, things seen or things not seen?
Things seen.
And our life is going to be, we are going to live all our life on things not seen. So how much are we thrashing the children to become masters in things seen?
Yes.
And then when they take decision on things seen and they land up in a trouble, now you're saying, why you can't pray and believe in things not seen? But who gave the thrashing?
Yeah. Yes.
Sorry, brother. Gerald is no more. Okay. Gerald Pinto is no more. Shanti here.
Yeah, Shanti. I understand what you're saying.
Okay.
Father, we thank you, we praise you. That as your word says, that we are all here on a mission on this planet Earth. We have all come here to find purpose, assignment. And our life on Earth is to discover this purpose and discover this assignment. Father, we thank you that we who are seeking you have found our purpose, have found our assignment. But there are many who are baptized, O Lord, Christians, who till the last have never found their purpose or an assignment, because instead of seeking your kingdom, we ended up seeking the kingdom of this world. Thank you, Lord, for Brother Gerard, that as we were praying, O Lord, Lord Jesus, thank you for the baptism that he has in you. Just as you died and you were buried and God raised you from the dead, Romans 6 speaks that we are baptized in you. We are baptized in your death. We were buried with you, and the same God who raised you from the dead has raised Gerard for all eternity to be with you. Thank you, Lord Jesus, you said, in my Father's house there are many rooms, and I will myself come and take you to my Father's house. We have this assurance because we believe in you, that even though our body, our shell is left behind, but our spirit and soul lives with you forever. Just as the egg, when it cracks from inside and the chick comes out, the shell is of no use, but the chick is living. In the same way, this body which has come from dust goes back to the dust, O Lord. But what has come from you is your breath of life. And thank you that we believe in you, Lord. And it is through believing we have redemption, we have salvation. But we pray for those who never knew you. They are lost forever. We as Christians, O Lord, we have sorrow when our loved ones are dead. But our loved ones are only departing from earth to heaven. But what about those who do not know you? Our own friends, our own colleagues, our own neighbors, whom we have never ever introduced to Jesus. The day they die, we will never see them for eternity. Father, you have made us ambassadors of Christ. You have given each one of us the ministry of reconciliation. Let our life be a life of purpose, a life of an assignment, that we want to introduce you, Jesus, to everyone, to cast the seed in everybody's life. Whether they sprout or not, that's not our job, but to cast the seed is our job. And even when we cast, O Lord, it is you who is supposed to make the seed sprout. And we know you are the God who never desires or it is never your will that souls be lost, but each one makes it to heaven. So here we are, Father God, in the name of Jesus, thanking you that our precious brother Gerard was able to make it to heaven because of the sacrifice of Jesus on the cross. But we pray for those who are dying every moment and they do not know you. The biggest tragedy in a person's life is not death, but the biggest tragedy of in a person's life is not to know you. Death for a Christian is the best healing moment. That Paul began to say, death, where are you? Where is your stink? Come on, come and take me, death. And if you kill me, I will be with my master in an instant. And I long to be there. But death, if you can't kill me, I will preach the gospel till my last breath. So here's the news to you, Satan, and to death. If I live, I preach and bring more souls into the kingdom. And if I die, the longing to meet my master is fulfilled. And the very next moment, I'm in paradise with my Lord. For a true thermostat Christian, the joy is that he not only lives his life on earth, but by the time he goes back, he has taken thousands and thousands and lakhs of souls along with him who could make it to heaven, because he lived his life not for himself, but he lived his life for the kingdom. And kingdom people live a life to fulfill the assignment that God has for us. There are so many Christians, O Lord, who do not even know you. They are baptized by birth, but without a relationship. We pray now that not only Gerard has got peace with you because of the baptism, but through Gerard, there are so many who are touched and saved. Bless his family, his household, that they will not look at the sorrow, they will look at you, Jesus, who paid the price for Gerard to make it to heaven. We do not look at you, we do not look at our loved ones, but we look at you, who took the place to give joy and a great future, to give us salvation from curse and from bondage of sin and from hell. The shackles are broken, the chains are broken, and you have set us free. Thank you and praise you for this, O glorious God, that we who are new creation, we do not live our life for ourselves, but we live our life for others. Thank you. Thank you for this facility you have given us, that we want to use this platform all the days of our life. Thank you and praise you for healing Brother Gerard permanently for eternity, where he is going to be experiencing no more sickness, disease, or pain, or sorrow of any kind, but only your goodness. Thank you, we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 So even now, what has happened is, if I see it from the natural mind,
yeah,
I cannot bear the sorrow. But the moment I understand the spiritual mind,
yeah,
I can only thank Jesus for all the days that he has given us. Live this life of victory. The question is, brother, every day, by the time I reach the finishing line, whom did I live my life for? Did I truly live my life for the kingdom? Or did I truly live my life to build my own kingdom? The greatest tragedy of a Christian is when he goes and stands before God and God shows him his plans. And then you will begin to realize what a great plan God had for each one of us.
Yeah.
It is our own flesh, our own blood.
Yeah.
Who has failed miserably, not responding to the gospel. Thank you, Jesus. So, the challenge is, how quickly can you get your mind off of the problem and begin to think on things that are not seen?
Yeah.
The things I desire, the things I don't see with my physical eye, I must learn to see the answer by the eye of faith. So when the word says that things which are seen are subject to change, are temporary, the Lord is teaching us that things which are seen are not permanent. They are subject to change.
Yeah.
All physical, natural eye things which are seen through my natural eyes, every one of them are subject to change through spiritual laws.
Yeah.
So even though what I see with my eyes, I'm not willing to agree with the word of God or the promises of God, the world system shapes the seen things around me. And these physical things, they seem to be so real. And they are real.
Yeah.
But the word of God says that they are all subject to change.
Yeah.
They're all temporary, and each one subject to change. Praise God.
Praise God.
So God's word is that force. It's a force applied on the image of things not seen. I repeat again, it's a force that is applied to the things that are not seen.
Yeah. Okay.
So when you are believing in the things not seen, will you allow your circumstances or the cares of life to create images within us and dictate terms over us and make us slaves? No. You don't have to tolerate them. You have to fight against them. So God's word exchanges things that are seen. The things that you don't desire.
Yeah.
It takes all those things and gives you things which are seen.
Yeah.
So that you begin the ministry yourself of using a small number and then speaking your desire till the numbers begin to multiply and you have got great network, great works that when you see your life, your life is transformed. But the things that you don't desire, you don't even have anything to do with them, just get rid of them. So God is the God who turns things from the seen to the unseen. Praise God, brother.
Praise God. You're sleepy?
Hey, you know, from the time this has happened, I get 1 hour, 1.5 hours sleep. And then in between there are calls. So I answer calls.
Yeah.
Sometimes when I'm answering calls also, I don't know what I'm answering. But praise God, they come back and they say still the job is done. So now I was on a transaction where the PIN code was not matching. I was trying my best to call the priest. But I could not get him on the line. So I sent him a message. Now I don't know. Yeah, it's done. You got it through. So when you're setting up these things and make them work, it's like, you know, on one side is the preaching, on the other side is this. Then you can't you know, balance both, but you keep doing it. So today's class also, I was there in the morning, but then I missed because there is another boy who left home and got stranded in US. So he's at the airport and he doesn't have a place to go. Every 1 hour I'm calling him up and saying things are happening. So he just, his visa got sanctioned. So now he has to go for a PCR and then book his flight ticket and get him on flight so that he comes back home.
Okay.
So people take wrong choices, thinking that the dream on the other side is very good. When they land and they see what happens, then they're so much shattered that the confidence is gone and the brokenness is so high. So it's painful. Praise God.
Praise God.
So this is how life is, brother. And the who are the ones who will win? The ones who walk in faith. So the ones who are walking in faith, remember, faith is evidence of things not seen. What does that mean? People who learn quickly to shift from things seen to unseen are the ones who are winners. And people who are thinking, no, I'll be praying long prayers for so many hours, their life is still in pain, brother. Because if they don't understand the system and they're praying, it will never work. God's kingdom system is very accurate. And you stick to that accuracy, the result also is very accurate and in multiples.
So why do we need to pray for a long time? Sometimes you need to pray for a long time.
The prayer is that you are enjoying your fellowship with God. Our prayer is more of the petition, brother.
No. So even if it's spiritual, you know, even in the spiritual things, you know, it does not just happen just like that, right?
When you met Sharu, okay, were you doing kuchu kuchu, talking?
Yes.
Let's talk. I'll give you an example.
Yeah.
Were you talking?
Yes.
And after midnight also you are talking?
Yes.
Now why at 9 o'clock you are sleeping?
She'll also sleep.
Jude, tell us, Jude is giving you special comments. Yeah, Jude.
He's in Sabbath rest now.
Sabbath rest. So, brother, at that time, okay, that passion, that zeal, that you want to talk to her, you want to know her, you won't even go to sleep.
At that time,
phone also was not there, no, that taka-taka was there. That time to just give a letter also was such a big pain.
Yeah.
And then you sent a letter. How many times the letter would be open? How many letters? There were so many cuts on the letter, but the letter was so much.
Yeah.
It is about your relationship.
No, no. My question is.
That's what I said. Relationship, brother. You go all round the bush. Oh. If it is relationship, you'll enjoy. Yeah. Even if you make a mistake, no, you'll enjoy.
Yeah.
In that relationship. But yeah. If it's not relationship, and it's like, you know, I come to God like, you know, you like a ATM machine. Okay, I came, I put the code, now give me.
Hmm.
No relationship.
Yeah. So you are saying that all the things should work in the relationship, not on a
otherwise you are just now you're saying I did know, now give me.
Yeah.
Like children might be saying, no, I prayed this, I did all these studies. Now, mom, give me this.
Yeah. Correct.
Now, if I unmute Jesse, no, all that volcano will come out. Want to see? Just unmute. Just mute and see how the volcano will open up. See, watch.
Brother, when we say Jesus, I trust in you. You trust him. Whether things work, don't work, but the greater plan he knows. And my focus is Jesus. My goal is Jesus. We are only sojourners, so I'm seeking him and I want to follow him. And it's a step by step walk. It doesn't happen overnight. You don't run.
Say that again.
It's a step by step walk.
You know what Jose wants? He wants Sharu at the top in one. In, you know, press the button, and Sharu is fully madly in love with him. It doesn't happen that way. You ask him how many hours did he invest to get to know her?
Yes. It is a walk. There is a struggle. There is a fight in your mind. But every time you trust in the word, and he fulfills everything, even our weaknesses, he transforms in his time. It happens. But it does happen.
So you tell him, how does he tell about Sharu? She took so many years. But with God, he wants it in one button.
God is God, no, brother.
So it's a step by step.
You are not God, no.
We are a step by step walk. It never happens. It's not a run. It's not a
leap. Listen, every day that little you get, no, it's such an addiction that you come the next day for more.
Yeah.
Jude, am I troubling you again?
Jude?
Sorry, Jose.
No. I'm just asking, you know, all these questions are not just only for myself, but a lot of people.
Yeah. I know.
A lot of people who are, you know, maybe as fresh as I am or as ignorant as I am are also part of this group. So, for the benefit of them, I sometimes ask these questions, even though
So it is on purpose, deliberately.
Yeah.
You are forcing yourself.
Yeah.
And you're saying, Lord, I want to have what started deliberately and forceful. Mm. Now it's no longer forceful. Now it's by default you want to do it.
Yes.
And even when you're doing it, no, you yourself begin to wonder, I never had this attitude. I never had this nature. I never had this behavior. How come all these changes took place? I'm not this person. I'm not this kind of a person. How did this change take place? Yeah. And then you begin to realize it's the love of God that makes you change. And it's not a, like Jesse said, no, it's not that you press the button and it happens.
Yeah.
It's every day, little by little.
Yes.
That is why it's a whole day called Kuchu Kuchu. Yeah. Kuchu Kuchu.
Correct.
Kuchu Kuchu. Yeah. And when that Kuchu Kuchu is happening with Jesus, no? Kuchu Kuchu with everybody becomes all right.
Yeah.
If that Kuchu Kuchu with Jesus is not right, no? Then with everybody it's going wrong.
Yeah.
So how do you know if this person is really in the Lord? The proof is that his horizontal relationship becomes good.
Mm.
And how does he practice the relationship with God? By practice horizontally.
Yeah.
So anybody who wants to grow in love with God, no?
Mm.
He should grow, he should practice horizontally. By default, he'll become strong with vertically.
Yes.
Because to practice horizontally, you can't do it on your own. You need his power, his strength.
Hmm. So somebody is asking this question. Janel, why does someone struggle to understand and accept the love of God? Why does someone struggle to understand and accept the love of God?
If only you begin to wonder and think, what was the price paid to save you?
No. So what she's asking is...
So that's when you are begin to realize how much he loves you.
Why is not everyone able to understand this?
Because everybody has got different distractions. Now, do you think I was able to understand before? See, there is something called as hardening of heart. Hardening of heart means a person is sensitive to something else. So if a person is hardened his heart towards the world, by default is very, very sensitive to God. And if the same person is very sensitive to the world, by default he has hardened his heart towards God. Whether you like it or not, you are sensitive to something or the other in this world. But the question is, are you sensitive to things which are pleasing in God's sight? Or are you going through a journey of pleasing your flesh?
That is a point. That is a very valid point, brother. So if you harden your heart towards the world, you'll be sensitive to God. And if you harden your heart towards God, you'll be sensitive to the world.
So that's why he told no Smith Wigglesworth, keep that out and come. Oh. He has hardened his heart so much towards the world that it does not tolerate even a second of the world to enter his home.
Oh, that is a commitment. Is it a response to the grace?
One moment. We always blame God. Huh? God gives brother pray that we give the grace.
I'm not blaming God. I'm trying to understand. Was it his response? What is the pattern that he followed? Was it his response to the grace? What was it? How do you?
So grace is given to everybody, the same.
Yeah, I understand. I have no debate on that. There is
absolutely. So when you are seeking more and more knowledge of God, the Lord says grace and peace is multiplied. So what that father was doing, he was learning the scriptures from the Gospels and all that. He was trying to get more knowledge because he is already preparing himself for death. But what he did not understand in the beginning is, he stepped into grace. Grace is the power of God that helps you to overcome any kind of weakness. So the more and more you get the knowledge, the more and more grace is multiplied. The more and more grace is multiplied, the more and more you respond with faith. Now grace is multiplied on one side, faith is multiplied on the other side. Now within a month or two, you'll see your life is transformed.
Amen.
Yeah. Did you understand? Jude?
Yeah.
Jude, did you understand? Amen.
Amen. No, my question was, from where did the centurion get his faith?
The centurion got his faith because he heard about Jesus. He heard about Jesus, and that's why he sent... He came to meet Jesus and said that I'm not worthy that you should enter my roof. But because I'm also a man of authority, when I give orders, my soldiers hear, and you are a man of authority, that even the whole of the kingdom of heaven, of hell or of darkness hear you. And that's why I'm asking you.
That's a point.
Okay, you just saw, no, Jude, what he did? Jude, what he did? Praise God. Yeah, brother, praise God.
Man, I'm just stretching my muscles.
Yeah, I know. It stretches exactly at 7 o'clock. 7, because otherwise afterwards also I will keep on stretching, so yeah. Give him 5.
Okay. Okay. So we will
so ultimately, brother, am I forcefully pulling myself in the right direction to learn to look at things not seen? So the more and more you study the word, by default you end up becoming a person living by things not seen.
Okay. Not the other way around. Amen.
The world is making our children champions in things seen. And now we take the children to church or to a prayer meeting, and when they are small, we are forcefully stripping them of those things which are not of the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
What do you think must be the condition of those in Dubai? The children. Talking about the children who are also getting a costume.
Where?
Praise God.
Yeah.
Hey, I spoke of my
mind.
Okay, let's close now.
Today we went to Kanyakumari. Today we went to Dubai.
So you see, brother, my sleep is like this.
I am not.
I'll tell you. My sleep is like this that God has given me is I can be talking and go into a snooze for 3 minutes and charge my battery and come back and continue my job.
Yes.
I don't get peed like people lie down on the bed and you sleep for 6 or 8 hours. Mm. I don't have that facility. Mm. My sleep is in between the gaps. Whatever little I get, snooze. And when I have to talk, I don't know what is running in my mind.
Yeah.
So please bear with me. Suddenly some sentence comes out. It is only because of that reason.
You are absolutely forgiven, brother.
but the joy is, brother, this has been happening for so many years like that. And I've been living like this all my life. So this is how I live. Yeah. And I enjoy this life.
Yes.
With the Lord, with the Holy Spirit, day and night. And no more desires what this world has to offer only.
Yeah.
Yes, it doesn't mean it doesn't knock at the door. But the desires of the kingdom of heaven is far, far superior than these other desires.
Yeah. So let us close. Thank you, Father. We worship you for this evening.
Yes, Lord.
Message this evening. Lord, we also pray for Shanti Pinto, her family. Lord, yes. to bear the loss they had. Lord, you are always there with all those who call upon your name. We thank you for being with her right now, for strengthening her and her family. We thank you, Jesus, for all of us who have been given this opportunity to learn this, to learn your word. And thank you, Lord, that whatever we learned may produce fruits for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you, brothers and sisters. We will meet tomorrow. God bless you all. Bye-bye.